The Arcane Odyssey Nimbus C update is closer than ever before. It's looking pretty clear that this is going to be the biggest update to Arcane Odyssey since release. To grasp the true extent of this update, we're going to look at every single sneak peek for it. In this video, we are going to look at every, and I mean every single sneak peek related to the Nimbus C update. But we might skip over some tiny little patch notes, which would make this video too long. But hold on, just before we get into it, I want to remind you that we are on the way to 1,000 subscribers. We only need around 300 more, so it would really help if you could subscribe. Anyways, on with the video. Now, this is the first patch note since the November update, which was the last big update to the game. In this patch note, it adds screen shake to cutscenes, regardless if it's turned off or not, which makes sense, looks cool. And next is, after defeating General Argos and defeating King Calvis, you're given a lasting injury that reduces your maximum health slightly, which is just basically story stuff, makes the story more immersive, and that's cool and all. One thing that I think this might be relevant to is in a Nimbus C, this might actually happen during some boss fights, which is going to be pretty cool. 2 days later, the Nimbus C place was added. This basically added the Nimbus C place, which means like servers for it, and added the way to access it, which is a wall from like behind Mount Othrys. You go through it, your ship gets teleported to the next place, and bam. It's like an invisible barrier, like the Dark Sea one. Anyways, that's basically it. And then 2 days later, they added in the new ship storage system, which basically allows you to put any ship, I mean, chests, barrels, cargo, into your ship storage so that it'll be able to teleport through. Basically, it's kept as in like a number and stuff. Also, if your ship sinks with like stuff in the storage, only half of the stuff will survive. So, it's basically pretty good for anything, unless you're like giving your treasure to a friend or something. That's it. Over the next few days, VTEX added in a new story island, a new wilderness island, and the first chapter of the Nimbus Sea. The biggest change, I'd say, would be that now ship storage gets completely wiped, like everything in it gets destroyed, which occurs upon sinking or combat logging, which stinks. But it also makes sense, that would be too open for Dark Sea. And for the rest of December, they added a few new chapters in Nimbus Sea, but that was pretty much it. Except for one big thing on New Year's Eve. First off, VTEX raised the level cap to 129 and changed the stat requirements for the scroll moves such as Pulsar, Surge, Slash, Uppercut, Celino from 100 up to 150 and 160 up to 240, which basically meant to reflect the lore strength of the character, which I guess it's good. Makes things a bit more balanced for the Nimbus C when it comes out. And of course, here is the roadmap. I'm not going to talk about it since it's not directly related, but you can look at it right now. The next patch note after the new year added in some basic things, but I'd say the biggest thing was that he added in the new boss drops and weapon for the newest boss at that time, of course. Which is pretty cool that we have at least a few bosses. Now this is a big one, but I'd say the biggest key things is that the claiming flag is no longer an item. It's just automatically in your bag if you're in a clan. Next, max galleons is now 5 million, which is a lot, but makes sense. Some people have that much. And then weapons no longer have upgradableness. They instead just have minimum levels, which means that even if you haven't upgraded your weapon, it'll deal a bunch of damage, which is I guess a buff to warriors now, since they don't have to spend money to upgrade their weapons, which is pretty nice. Anyway, this is a small one, but pretty important. Now you can see how much each stat actually affects what you're having, which is such as intensity, agility, attack size, and attack speed, which is pretty nice. And as well, health regeneration now only scales with base health and vitality, not defense, which is nice. I love combat, works the same though. Also, now health regen in combat is only minus 25 instead of minus 50 of the out of combat rate, which basically means you'll be you're going to be regenerating more health, which is in compensation for the defense loss. And now come in the build related items such as Arcanium and strength items. First off, here's some important things. Now, Arcanium items automatically convert to the owner's magic. Second, Arcanium items now have a little blue dot which tells that they're a magic item, which basically tells them that they're special. And third, really important, is that Arcanium items now have altered stats by the type of magic. Example, earth gives defense, fire maybe power, intensity, and light, speed, whatever. Basically, magic affects stats now, which is cool. Also, he added the new Arcanium helmet, armor set, whatever. To summarize the rest of January, they just added in some new armor sets, such as the more Arcanium, some fighting style armor sets, and a bit of vitality, which is pretty nice. Also, new stats, but we'll talk about them in the group later. But now, what we've all been waiting for, Sumeria, the biggest island in the Nimbus Sea and the largest populated island in the game so far. This is just so cool. This is awesome. Absolutely amazing. And now it's going to start picking up from here. Here are some new armor sets that VTech showed off right after this. And here are the stats I was talking about. We have the new Resistance, Armor Piercing, and Regeneration. Resistance grants damage res while using attacks, such as just the charge up and the end lag. Armor Piercing is how much damage pierces through defense, resistance, and blocking, which just means you do more damage to blocks. And Regeneration just buffs your health regen, which is nice. Now, this is just repeated from before, but here is the Nimbus Sea border and the new ship storage system. Cool. And don't forget about the Arcane Odyssey Q&A, which basically just shows off a bit of Sumeria, but also answers a bunch of questions, so go take a look at it if you want. But one cool thing that was confirmed in it was that there will be frequent updates after this, so like every month, every few weeks, there'll be an update, which is going to be better than just drowning, choking the game of updates, which is nice. So, what after? Well, the thing is, that was a week ago, which means we're pretty much caught up. The only small thing is that Sumeria has been completed with quests, which is nice. But yeah, that's basically the end of the video. Anyways, if you can, I'd like you to subscribe, it'd be really nice. But it's over. I'll see you guys there, and bye-bye. Bye. I just said that twice. See ya.